let's go through, though, everything that is wrong with PETA. And unfortunately, you may think that it doesn't affect you, but it does to a very large degree. So let's go through five fast facts. Let's go to things that also suck. PETA, this is something that's important because they're now, and I love this, though, that Budweiser is getting it from all sides. You know, they're being boycotted by conservatives. And by the way, some people are saying, actually, their stock value has gone up over time. Well, here's the thing. This is not, the sales are not going to be coming in until, you know, the next quarterly earnings report. They're not going to be coming in until the next sales call, which is probably going to be in August. Right now, this is about people basically trying to plump up the stock. The sales are going to reflect the long-term future of Budweiser. There are a lot of games that they can play, especially as it relates to ESG. But if you look at what's happening across the country, when you're looking at bars, when you're looking at places that are no longer stocking it, okay, keep the pressure on. I don't care what some Republicans tell you. But they're also getting it from the other side, from PETA, because PETA is furious about the Clydesdales commercials.
Really?
So especially after Budweiser just tried to win you back without apologizing by releasing this generic, in case you've forgotten, we don't need to run the whole thing, but Budweiser brought back the Clydesdales in this new pseudo-patriotic commercial, hoping that you forgot that someone who was mentally deranged got their own commemorative can.
Right.
Let me tell you a story
about how to ruin a company.
Beer. Rooted in the heart of America.
Oh my God.
You mean Belgium?
Found in a community where a handshake is a sure contract.
Now with Don Lemon, it means more than that.
Brewed for those who found opportunity in challenge and hope.
That was Joe Scarborough, wasn't it?
Raised by generations, willing to sip. Share, risk, remember.
Oh, come on. I didn't
see
that
story.
What did I miss?
Bigger than beer. This is the story of the American spirit.
Really?
What does that even mean? And by the way, to a lot of people out there who are, you know, the whole like, I go to NASCAR, those people, and I do mean this, the middle Americans who are sometimes, just know, Michelob is also Anheuser-Busch. Bush Light. I've seen some people say, yeah. I'm pouring out my Bud Light and I got my Bush. You moron. You have to be just bothered to do a little bit of research. You're required to be responsible as a consumer today, okay? That is required of you.
Yeah, it's Bush.
Those are beautiful animals, though. Those Clydesdales.
Fantastic.
Oh.
But yeah. See, what are they? You know how they made the last one jump up like a, you know, the with rope carrots. Around the balls? Like they're doing the rodeo.
No, that's a Dylan Mulvaney.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
No, the thing that I was pissed about is that they used 9/11 remembering.
Yeah.
Because they're like, hey, let's tap into that for everybody.
That's because Dylan Mulvaney is the 9/11 of ambassadors.
Ooh. That's right.
I take down both companies.
Yeah. So here's the thing. So they did this ad. And by the way, those Clydesdales, they get treated unbelievably. These are show horses, right? These are not. So PETA's wrong in all facets. But here's something that you may not know. Okay, you know they suck. But you may not know why you absolutely despise PETA. And they have a storied history of actually killing animals and also wanting to take away your pets. Everything about PETA is wrong. And when you understand how much money they have and how they play a role also in the environmental lobbying organizations, which also, by the way, this is all connected, has played a role in what your dietary guidelines are, which leads you to making worse healthcare decisions and leads you to having worse health parameters and outcomes, you understand why this matters. PETA should have no influence. Unfortunately, they have far more than you know. So PETA is now protesting Anheuser-Busch for its use of the big horses. This is the jumping off point.
Free beer!
Find out why we're here!
Free beer!
Find out why we're here!
I did not know they could
you couldn't get a date?
Isn't that horrible? No. I mean, and they get them in their bones. They don't just cut their tails. You know? And the ice
cold beer.
Find
out why we're here!
We have about... There you go.
Budweiser has blood on its cans. Whatever.
Yay, beer!
So PETA
light on its cans. So does Hunter's dates at the end of the night.
So does Sam Brenton.
So PETA tweeted, instead of raising a glass for Budweiser's 90th anniversary, we're raising awareness of their cruel horse mutilation by passing out 90 bottles of Ripple White Ale. Like, remember, it was that they chose the crappy name. Remember Ripple Blonde wasn't Top Secret? That was the wine that burned down the glass. Just it was your Ripple Blonde, sir. And the glass just dissolves. But here's the thing, the crop tails, by the way, just so you understand, sometimes there's a purpose for that, just to be clear. I get it. I'm not a huge fan of it. So, for example, like Joe Louis, he's a Dogo Argentino. They often crop the ears of the dog. Why? Because they were bred to go out and hunt and protect the farms in Argentina from boar and cougar. You know what's worse than having cropped ears? Having a cougar claw it and rip it out. Now, Joe Louis doesn't hunt cougar or boar, so I don't need to crop his ears. The reason they often crop tails, they do this with horses, people can correct me if they're, you know, equestrians out there, is that crap gets stuck in there, it gets matted, and sometimes it also becomes a problem if they're in a pen when they're traveling and gets caught. It's for the better health of the animal. It's not
like
cruel.
It's like a horse ponytail.
Yes, exactly. Yes. Although, in many instances, I don't speak from first-hand experience, sometimes it's nice to have a handle.
Liar, whore, and you know it.
So, let's go through, though, everything that is wrong with PETA, and unfortunately, you may think that it doesn't affect you, but it does to a very large degree. So let's go through five fast facts. Fast fact number five. So PETA, they kill a lot of animals. And the 25 last years alone, PETA's Virginia shelter killed 50,000 animals.
Dang. Jeez.
The Virginia Department of Agriculture, they actually identified the shelter in Norfolk as, quote, the single largest killer of animals in the state, even surpassing the previous record held by Michael Vick's barbecue. This is one thing that you wouldn't assume that PETA euthanizes animals. Not only do they do that, and I'm not against the euthanization of animals, just to let you know, sometimes it is necessary, sometimes it is humane, but they do it at an exponentially higher rate than other places whose job it is to rehome animals. This is the thing that's important to note.
Yeah.
And I think Nick, it doesn't matter. Let's move on from this. Well,
it's safer. What happened? But I do.
It's safer.
you had something to run through that. Never mind.
I can't see. I'm blind.
Now you tell us.
Am I supposed to be watching this map?
I was trying to cue you on your own joke that was hilarious.
You think I can remember what I said to you an hour ago?
I don't think so. No.
Oh, my God.
We'll bring it into the scrapyard show tomorrow.
Behind the paywall.
So in 2022 alone, PETA killed over 2,000 dogs and cats. Okay? Just to give you an idea, they had a 74% kill rate in their shelter.
Yeah.
Okay, and a 2.1% adoption rate. Now, that doesn't matter unless you have the contrast, right? The average Virginia animal shelter, they have a 5.2% kill rate and a 74% adoption rate. So a 74% kill rate for PETA versus a 5% kill rate for another animal shelter in the same state.
Well, just to add a little context on the cats, some have said that that's a good start.
Some have said
just
that.
Just saying, not all animals are equal.
Yes.
It's a higher kill rate than Chris Kyle in Iraq.
Yes.
Oh, wow. I asked the lady at the airport, she had her kid, I'm not kidding you, yesterday, had her little daughter on a leash, and I asked if it was a rescue.
And after you were hauled out in cuffs, what happened?
She goes, what? And I went, nothing.
Really? She didn't laugh?
She looked like she had a sense of humor.
But she didn't.
No.
No, of course not.
I guess the tie-dye t-shirts in the 5 o'clock shadow should have given that away.
Oh, you met Sam at the... You got to stop meeting people at the carousel at LaGuardia. So in 2014, in response to PETA's killing and all, Virginia actually passed SB 1381, I think. Mm-hmm. 1381. That defined a private animal shelter as, quote, a facility operated for the purpose of finding permanent adoptive homes for animals. This bill might as well read, we're looking at you, PETA!
Yeah, they promptly lobbied against the
bill. Yes, PETA lobbied against the bill. So they not only kill at an astronomical rate, they then use their many, 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 many tens of millions of dollars in funding to continue killing at an astronomically high rate. I wish I loved anything as much as PETA loves killing animals. But it starts with a lie, right? It starts with this premise that, well, everyone wants to treat animals better, of course.
But I thought I've always thought of PETA as being the place that animals are saved. That they're rehomed, that they're put out in some pasture to live wild and free and happy for the rest of their lives.
Most people think PETA does two things. They save animals and they throw red paint on ladies with fur coats.
Well, I know
instead, they kill animals. and then they do the second one. So one out of two ain't bad.
Funny billboards every once in a while. Like, yeah, if a shark ate you, it's, I guess it's fair or something like that. I'm like,
they always, they go too far.
Yes.
In the 80s, they were upset because they were using monkeys to try to find a cure for AIDS.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And I said, if hooking a monkey's brain up to a car battery is going to save somebody from dying AIDS, I got two things to say. Red is positive and the black is negative. And there's a tag to that joke. I can't remember.
I agree. Let's go to fast fact number four. The budget from PETA. So here's something you may not know. Here was their treasure chest in 2019. Their budget, almost $56 million.
Oh, my goodness.
Then another $16 million in assets. Only $7 million in liabilities. So, and then their fund balance at the end of it was something like $8 million. The point is they have an unbelievable amount of cash. Here's where they spend their money, PETA. International grassroots campaigns, which may include what you just saw with Budweiser, throwing red paint on fur coats, $15 million. Public outreach and education, $32 million. Whoa. Just to be clear, that also involves lobbying. Mm-hmm. These people have a... When people bitch about the NRA, first off, none of it comes close to the teachers' unions. Why aren't we talking about PETA? And we'll get to how that affects the American Health and Dietary Associations, the American Health Association, our Heart Association. All of these things are interconnected, and it all stems from secular humanism. Research, investigations, and rescue. $23 million. A cruelty-free merchandise program. I don't even know how you do that when you're killing 74% of your animals.
Well, it's not cruel.
Yeah, I guess.
Sarah McLachlan, hair and makeup, $7 million.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Not to mention, I mean, they couldn't extend the contract, but when they had Melissa Etheridge, it's like, I don't know why they have all of them.
But there's one
yeah,
more.
What's the connection?
Catch in my window!
Yeah, there was an expense in there for $325 for one bathtub to drown the animals.
Yes. So, no, you got Michael Vick's.
Yeah.
That's his Lowe's.
That's
cheap bathtub.
Tab.
Gerald, you're savage.
Here's something else you may
I'm
not know
angry.
About PETAs, right? You're talking about PETA. Here's fast fact number three.
I missed.
PETA, actually, a lot of people think PETA is for pet owners. PETA doesn't believe in pet ownership. If you look at PETA originally, they had a radical stance, and it's been reiterated today. They don't believe that you should be able to own pets, but they don't really talk about that so much. Okay, the pet ownership that, this is from 1983, too. The cat, like the dog, must disappear. We should cut the domestic cat free from our dominance by neutering, and more neutering until our pathetic version of the cat ceases to exist. This is, and what they'll do is they'll do this, and then, of course... Why would you do that? Joe Louis is fine. He's right here.
Yeah.
Joe Louis, come on over here. Joe Louis.
Over there, Joe Louis.
Joey. Come on, show everyone that you're fine. Come here.
Yeah,
Joe.
Boy.
Come on, he's fine.
He's happy, guys. Come on.
Oh, he is happy. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right.
See? That looks like fun.
No, I just have to go.
He just did one and he's out.
Here, look. I'm going to carry you over. Oh, now you... Now.
Oh my God!
Get him! Get him!
He's got. Do you know what this equipment cost? Joe,
he looks happy.
Okay. He's alive and well.
Come on, guys! He doesn't need to be a part of that commercial.
That was ridiculous. Yo, nobody's sticking pencils in his eyes and stuff.
Not.
Well, you had the comment before about getting his ears all.
Yeah.
Yeah. By the way, he just blew an intern off their feet. He's.
We have good insurance for a reason, folks.
Right. Yeah.
Yes.
So let's go to fast fact number two.
Got him.
This is going really well. PETA actually steals and kills pets. Did you know that?
Give me the address to my house.
Yeah.
I got a shih tzu that won't shut the fuck up. Anyways, go ahead. Sorry.
I thought you were making another wife joke.
I was going there too.
Not enough strays. We got to go into backyards.
I can't do that.
No, you can't.
I love the wife.
Yes, of course. So, someone help me. So, They steal and kill pets. Here's two PETA associates, right? They actually, this is a story that you may have heard of. All the references are publicly available. They took a family's pet from the property and euthanized the animal on the same day.
Dang.
So here's from The Guardian. Two women affiliated with PETA went on to Zerat's home and took their unattended and unleashed chihuahua named Maya. Maya was put down later that day. The family sued PETA and won $49,000. And of course, PETA denied the allegations, calling it a terrible accident. That was all they said to defend themselves.
I thought they blamed a Chinese restaurant.
Yes. They also run a Chinese restaurant. That's part of their operating budget. It's research.
We need one more for the quota. All right, I'll be back.
Yes.
This little yapper down the streets had it coming.
I said no MSG. Oh, I thought you said more chihuahua.
Oh.
Why would I say that? I don't know. I thought it was weird, too. What do we do now? Your guess is as good as mine.
Shih Tzu and broccoli. Yes.
Don't waste it.
Tastes very good.
Yes, it's a Pomeranian beef. You should say what? Mongolian. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So
we'll go with that.
Here's the final fact that you guys need to know. That this affects not just PETA, but all these secular humanist organizations who don't want you not only to eat meat or drink milk or eat eggs. They want you to eat bugs and like it. This is a part of international government agreements and treaties. This is what they're pushing you toward. They don't want you to have choice. So here's an example of New York City Mayor Adams actually just echoing this sentiment, declaring war on meat and dairy.
One in every 5 metric tons of carbon dioxide our city emits comes from food. But all food is not created equal. The vast majority of food that is contributed to our emission crisis lies in meat and dairy products.
Does that affect, doctor?
We already know that a plant-powered diet is better for your physical and mental health. And I am living proof of that. But the reality is that thanks to this new inventory, we're finding out it is better for the planet.
I am proof of that. You've heard of endomorphs and ectomorphs. I am a body type of retarded turtle. Here's a Swedish chef next to me. What'd you, he says smorgy burger. I don't know why he is. And that's wrong. It's not correct, just to be clear. And it's also worse for the environment, to be clear, when you understand what happens if everyone moves to plant-based diet. Okay, so let me kind of lay this out for you. A lot of people, and I want you to conduct this experiment at home. Hit the like button, by the way, if you're watching on YouTube, and comment below if you knew about this. Let me get to it, and then I'll ask you the question, because there's some information that you need. Yeah, you should get off YouTube. So a lot of our dietary guidelines are not based on health at all. You just heard that right there, right? That was a perfect encapsulation. It's about politicization. Mm-hmm. And that stems from the idea of the environment and what is seen as progressive. So I'd like you to do this experiment. Okay, MyNet Diary, I believe, is the biggest place where you can go, you know, and log your food and your calories. Okay, so I went in and did this myself. So I went in and I entered in a ribeye steak. So ribeye steak from a farm, you know, good ranchers from a farm where I know it comes from. I know the nutritional profile. The rating was a D.
Well, that's wrong.
Okay. A whole egg rating was a B minus. Goat milk that a lot of people don't like, but it's about as healthy as B minus. Now let's contrast that with Honey Nut Cheerios. It's an A minus.
It's science.
Are you serious?
Lucky Charms is a B plus. I'm saying, let me go even worse. Cheetos is a B.
What?
Eggs, that should be an A.
Eggs and goat's milk were B minus, and Cheetos are a B, and ribeye is a D.
Oh, my God.
And they use what the American Heart Association and the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics, okay? These are the people who they use as a reference point for these guidelines that you follow, that Mr. Adams, Mayor Adams, believes is healthier. Well, let me give you a little bit of a backstory on this, on the American Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics. It's really long. Let's just go with an acronym. In 2019... major global food and beverage companies, they committed to this WHO trans fat pledge. Okay, well, by the way, too.
It's not the same as trans. It's just
yes, fat. Exactly. Well, okay. Let me give you first a couple of examples. Okay, the American Heart Association. All right. Then you look at the American Association of Dietetics and Nutrition. These people are funded largely by a huge amount of funding comes from pharmaceutical companies. Now, I'm not saying big pharma, man. What I'm saying is it comes from these companies as well as snack food companies. It does defy reason. And everything that we know, when you think, hold on a second, a ribeye from a local farm, I would be better off on a diet of Cheetos and Lucky Charms than, say, ribeye steak and whole eggs. That is what they are telling you. That is what they advise. And by the way, these people are in agreement with PETA. It all stems from this neo-environmentalism. You can go back and look at McDonald's. McDonald's used to use beef tallow in their fries.
Yeah.
And what happened? They said, well, actually, that's really bad for your health. That's bad for your heart, saturated fat. But there was a subtext there, too. There were a bunch of environmental lobbyist groups who said, no, we should use hydrogenated seed oils. Turns out that's worse for you than beef tallow.
Yeah.
And so now they've decided to go to other oils that aren't trans fats but aren't animal fats. So this is actually something right now that they have applied this pledge, the WHO, to phase out industrially produced trans fat from the global food supply by 2023. Here's the thing. The neo-environmentalist group doesn't want them to do that. Why? Because the replacement, because it can't be beef, it can't be tallow, it can't be that saturated fat, but trans fats are really bad for you, would largely be palm oil. And that is what, it's bad for the environment. It's bad for the environment. And the American Heart Association, by the way, who also advises the World Health Organization, they received $6.2 million from AstraZeneca, Pfizer, $767,000. Verily, which is Google Life Sciences, $5.4 million. Now, I know what you're saying, that they also get a bunch of small donations. Sure, but if they have membership dues and you're paying, let's say, $20, $30 a year,
yeah,
and they have a pharmaceutical company paying $6.2 million a year, to whom are they going to be beholden? Or if it's PepsiCo, to whom are they going to be beholden? That's why you have your diet calculator tell you that Cheetos are a-okay, but you know what? Stay away from that New York strip. That could clog your arteries.
So let me get this straight in this segment. It's good to eat animals.
It's better for you than eating Cheetos.
I think that's the takeaway.
Yeah.
I like it.
I do believe that an animal-based diet is probably the best diet that you can eat.
Well, they lose. We win.
Yeah. No, I mean, honestly, I think that as far as being healthy, and that's primarily what it is meat, and then you can have some vegetables, we should not be eating nearly as much, not because of gluten, okay? I'm not a pussy.
No.
Just all of this crap, we know trans fats are bad for you. We know that now. It's been acknowledged, even internationally. But environmentalist groups and groups like Peter saying, no, hold on a second. Screw humans. We know that we're giving them all kinds of chronic health problems and potentially damaging, actually, their internal, and by the way, which could be generational, depending on the amount of damage that we're doing at this point. But you know what? Hold on a second. Palm oil, that could be bad for the environment.
Good for your dick.
Yes. You're thinking of palm heart palms. What's the term in English?
Heart of palms.
Okay, because I'm thinking, the French term.
Heart of palms. That's artichokes.
Artichokes. It's the same thing, right?
Oh, is it? I don't know. When you said
what
palms.
What just happened? What just happened here?
I thought it was a religious. The palms you get on Palm Sunday.
Oh, palms.
I think we all just had a stroke.
Yeah.
We all got very
confused. I think I caused it.
I thought you were saying artichokes.
Well, look, a while back they had an opportunity to kind of decide on what we were going to focus on for food health, right? So to see like what is going to be healthy, what are we going to focus on? It was calories that we chose instead of sugar and carbs, basically.
That it was saturated fat.
Yeah, right. And then it moves to this, and it's like, guys, you're missing the boat on all of this. As parents, when you go right now and you're looking at food, most of the time you don't turn it over and look at the calorie count in it, because that's usually pretty low for kid stuff. You look at how much added sugar is in it, because you know what it does to your child immediately. Not just long-term health, but you know they're going to be bouncing off the walls.
Yeah.
So you're telling me those cereal brands, turn that box over.
Yeah.
Look at how much of your daily intake of carbohydrates is in there. Look how much added sugar is in there. Look how much processed crap is in there.
Right.
Now, give me that steak.
Well, they even changed, by the way, totally internationally, they've acknowledged that cholesterol is not nearly as important of a marker as like C-reactive protein inflammation, which is increased dramatically far more by insulin resistance, by over-intake of sugar, and not by simply saturated fat.
Right.
Now, you don't want to become dogmatic and eat only saturated fat, like some of these carnivore diet people, like, all I eat is I just eat the fat from the steak and liver. I eat nothing else. I haven't taken a good dump in 4 months. So, look, eating a balanced diet that includes animal fat, your body needs it. Your body needs cholesterol. We know that now to produce hormones. So think, you can't come up with a more brilliant way to create, especially on 420, to create a generation of dumb, malnourished, weak, chronically ill, depressed people. Get rid of life-giving foods under the guise of environmentalism. I don't know, throw more weed at it.
I love it.
Yeah, no, sorry, Nick. What were you saying?
Oh.
I thought you were about to say something.
Yeah, I was. Yeah. I was going to say, how about, as far as the information about nutrients on the package, let's get rid of the, I don't know, get rid of the metric system.
Yeah.
Well, people don't know what about 1,500 milligrams of sodium is.
That's true. That's
seriously.
A good point.
Oh, yeah, salt.
Yeah, salt. Yeah.
That'll kill you.
Not that much.
No, but the metric system. Yeah, seriously, what is that about?
Well, actually, what would you do if you weren't doing grams or if you weren't doing milliliters?
You put, you know what?
I have no idea.
Ounces.
You put, yeah, I guess you could put, but yeah. I think it's too small. Huh? I think it's too small. There's too, I don't think
it would be like
0.00001 ounce.
That's right. Be American, will you?
I have no idea. I was doing the math in my head. I'm like, could we do that?
But is it not? Okay.
We could.
That is metric, is it not?
It is metric. It's very stupid.
Yeah, well.
It's a very stupid system, the metric system. Actually, yeah. It probably makes more sense. I don't know. I have no idea. I was raised in Canada where they say, we use the metric system.
Oh, that's right.
And I say, okay, how tall are you?
Yeah.
1.1 meter. I'm like, see, you're full of crap. They're not even consistent with it.
I get it. If they just weren't pricks about it, I'd be fine with it.
So this is the point here. When we're talking about PETA and they're protesting Budweiser, which is fun, you know, break off the pool cues, let them have tryouts. But you need to understand what's happening beneath the surface, the influence of, this is a war of ideology, of secular humanism. When they have acknowledged that this will harm people, right, continuing to feed them a bunch of hydrogenated vegetable oils that occur nowhere in nature and have unilaterally been condemned as bad for your heart. Mm-hmm. Is it, but no, but we care more about the environment, and they do all of this under the guise of, you know, just caring about animals, which is nice, I guess.
They care about killing. In the
arms of the angels. All right, guys, stop. He's fine.
He was fine a minute ago.
I told you he's okay.
What did you guys do to him?
Are you sure? I mean,
he's absolutely fine. Yes, okay. He's out there.
All right.
He just attacked the new intern.
Okay. I didn't know.
Watch Louder with Crowder live, Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.